हरि ओम फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम वंस अगेन टू सनातन दुनिया, योर स्पिरिचुअल होम. इन दिस वीडियो आई शैल बी गिविंग माई कॉमेंट्री ऑन द सेवेंथ श्लोका ऑफ दक्षिणामूर्ति स्तोत्रम. दक्षिणामूर्ति स्तोत्रम इज अ कॉम्पोजिशन एंड स्पिरिचुअल वर्क ऑफ विजडम बाय आदि शंकराचार्य, हु इज वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट मास्टर्स ऑफ सनातन धर्म एंड मेनली एज फार एज अद्वैत वेदांत इज कंसर्न. For those of you who have not yet listened to my commentaries on the five introductory prayers of this Dakshinamurti Stotram and the previous slokas of this work, I suggest you listen to them before continuing with this video. These videos are available in the video section of my channel and also in the playlist section of this channel in the playlist titled Adi Shankaracharya's Works of Vedantic Wisdom and Dakshinamurti Stotram with commentary in English, 11 parts. Before I go ahead and give my commentary on the 7th sloka of Dakshinamurti Stotram, I have a small request to make. If you have not already subscribed to my channel, then I suggest you do so, so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. So let's move on. The 7th sloka of the Dakshinamurti Stotram is as follows. He who, through the auspicious sign of knowledge, Jnana Mudra, reveals to his devotees his own self, which persists in all stages of age, childhood, boyhood, youth and old age, in all states, waking, dreaming and deep sleep, and in all other conditions, and who constantly manifests himself inwardly as I, to him the divine teacher Sri Dakshinamurti is this prostration. The commentary of this sloka is as follows. The Jnana Mudra is done by touching the tips of the thumb and the index finger together, forming a circle, and the hand is held with the palm inward towards the heart. Jnana Mudra balances Vayu in our body and steadies the mind. The thumb represents the supreme reality called Brahman. The forefinger represents the individual soul or Jiva or our inner reality. The two fingers touching each other signify the oneness of Brahman and Jiva. In other words, the individual self is not different from the supreme reality, Brahman. Adi Shankara says here in this sloka that like many yogis, Sri Dakshinamurti also holds the Jnana Mudra while meditating. Long and uninterrupted meditation along with a mantra like the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra or any other mantra for that matter, and simultaneously holding the hand in Jnana Mudra shall awaken the yogi to self-realization. So, by practicing this mudra and meditating upon a sacred mantra, Sri Dakshinamurti demonstrates to his disciples that by sincere and long and uninterrupted sadhana, it is possible for all conditioned souls to be transformed into realized souls. Of course, there is no technique which can guarantee results. As the Yoga Vashishta says, the enlightenment of the disciple will depend upon the quality of the disciple's consciousness. However, nobody can stop an individual from putting in effort towards the goal of self-realization. As Lord Krishna says in the Gita, we only need to do our sadhana regularly and not be attached to the fruit of the tapasya. Further, Adi Shankara is saying that the state of Nirvikalpa Samadhi which Sri Dakshinamurti reveals to his disciples is uniformly a state of pure consciousness or Shuddha Chaitanya which persists in all stages of age of the body, namely childhood, boyhood, youth and old age. It is only our body which is young or old. We as the self or consciousness are eternal and beyond time and space. We as the self were the same pure consciousness in childhood as we are now in our youth, and we shall remain the same self of consciousness even in old age. It is the body that grows older, not the self that we are. the self that we are is ageless and is not affected by the stages of the body. It is this ageless and timeless self which is the goal of yoga and Vedanta and all spiritual paths. And it is this self which is revealed by Sri Dakshinamurti and other realized masters like him to all of their disciples, devotees and seekers. Further, Adi Shankara is saying that not only is the self same in all ages and stages of the body, it is also likewise changeless and constant in all the three states of consciousness, namely waking, dreaming and deep sleep. As I had explained in earlier videos, the self that we are, when conditioned by Maya, goes through three states of consciousness, namely waking, dreaming and deep sleep. During the waking state, we as souls experience the gross world of names and forms through our gross body and mind. This entire creation which we experience during the waking state is unreal and is a projection of our own minds. In fact, there is no creation at all, yet we see it in front of us. This is only due to our ignorance of the self that we are and that self that God is. The day we attain self-knowledge, this world of names and forms shall disappear and we shall be established in a state of limitless bliss, happiness and freedom. During the dream state, our conscious mind switch off and with that the world appearance also disappears simultaneously. In that state, our subconscious mind projects a world of names and forms which is likewise also illusory. When we wake up from the dream state into the waking state, we realize that all the names and forms that we saw in the dream were all unreal and false. However, during the period of the dream world feels real. After the dreams conclude, we experience deep sleep, during which we are enveloped by darkness all around, in which there is neither the gross names and forms seen in the waking state, nor the subtle names and forms seen in the dream state. We experience a complete void or blankness without us being aware of it. We have no memory of our deep sleep. When we wake up from deep sleep, we say, "Oh, I slept well." So Adi Shankara is saying that though there are these three states of consciousness for all creatures, for a realized soul like Sri Dakshinamurti, there is only one uniform and homogeneous state of pure consciousness which continues unchanging through waking, dream and deep sleep. A realized soul goes through these states of consciousness consciously with full awareness. In the next part of this sloka, Adi Shankara says that the self in a realized soul like Sri Dakshinamurti constantly manifests himself as I inwardly. When a conditioned soul says I, he is normally referring to his ego or himself as the jiva. However, when a realized soul like Sri Dakshinamurti says I, he is normally referring to himself as the self or infinite consciousness. So Adi Shankara is saying that Sri Dakshinamurti constantly manifests himself inwardly as I, which is to say that he is ever established in the self and enjoys unlimited bliss and happiness, and thereby reveals to all his disciples how they too can lead a life of permanent happiness and freedom by abiding in the self and not giving room for worldly thoughts and worldly subjects. By following the sadhana prescribed by our respective sadgurus and along with selfless seva and satsang, we all too can elevate ourselves to the permanent state of nirvikalpa samadhi and thereby experience permanent happiness and freedom from the cycle of birth and death. Finally, Adi Shankara says, to him the divine teacher Sri Dakshinamurti is this prostration. I have already commented in the previous videos about prostration and its importance. the more we prostrate with devotional bhava or feeling to our Sadgurus and Ishtadevatas, the more we shall get the fuel of inspiration and strength to pursue the spiritual path until the very end of our lives. Prostrations to Sri Krishna, to Sri Shankaracharya, to Sri Dakshinamurti, and to all the masters of Sanatan Dharma and other religions of the world. So friends, here ends my commentary on the 7th sloka of Dakshinamurti Stotram. I shall be coming up with commentaries on the following slokas of this work in the days to come. So stay tuned to this channel, and if you like this commentary, then hit the like button. Also, kindly subscribe to this channel if you haven't already done so, so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day ahead. Hari Om.